Congressman, a while ago, you said that you got invited to a cabinet meeting and they listened to your suggestions. They heard what you had to say, implemented some of your suggestions as well. The question now is, how divergent will your stand be from the current administration's policies and agenda? Because that seems to be one criticism that has been hurled against you, Congresswoman, that you have not really been critical of this administration when you should be, that you have kept silent when you have spoken up, Congresswoman. Okay.
You know, Carmina, by nature, I'm a builder. I'm a creator. And we only have 24 hours in a day. And the work I do locally, regionally, nationally, and globally does not even give me enough time to build and to comply with all these. Now, I define my policy. If I'm divergent from the others, I say so in a statement, in a press release, I speak about it. But that is my way of conversing. I join the national discourse and I respect other people's opinions. Not everybody may think the way I do, just like I may not agree with some of the policies. And I say so calmly in the way I know how. And that's for people who know me, even when I debate in the Senate. I'm essentially a builder, and I believe that what we need in leadership now are people who can build, who can unify, who can heal. Kailangan natin ihilom ang mga sugat, hindi lamang sa politika, kundi na rin ang mga sugat ng pagsasamahan, sugat pa rin ng kalikasan, ng planeta, at kailangan natin pag-isa-isahin. Dahil kung hindi tayo sama-sama at walang unity, mahirap labanan ang kalaban na hindi natin nakikita. And I tell you, this pandemic will be more, just like the climate crisis, will be more intense, it will be more frequent, and as we see, there are different variants if we do not use science-based solutions. So as I said, there's so much to do, but for me to be very vocal and to about my views will entail a lot of energy, and my energy is focused on creating, building, and solving. It does not mean I will not speak my mind when I do not believe it is correct. I do. Maybe it's not seen on print or on digital all the time, but my statements will stand on record every day as my report card to the nation.
What do you say to those who still criticize you for being loyal to a president who has committed a lot of atrocities under his term? One of which, of course, is the closure of your home network. People still think of that day when they hear of your name. What do you say to those people?
Well, first of all, as you know, I'm one of the authors of the renewal of the franchise. And as you very well know as well, you saw my statement that at the time, I could not vote in favor. I had to abstain because I've ongoing programs on the network, on the station where you have. In fact, we just aired the result documentary, and I've ongoing programs at Dayaw. So it would not have been appropriate legally if I had voted in favor. So I believe that the network where I had glorious days of my life in the service of the Filipino must reapply for the franchise. I will help in any way, as I did behind the scenes, because I was not chairman of the committee. In terms of the voting, I adequately and sufficiently explained the legal reason why at the time I could not vote, because of the ongoing numerous airtime and programs that I was producing and involved with and hosting up to now with ANC. I wish I had cast the 13th or 14th vote. They know where my heart is, and it's been adequately explained for those who read my statement at the time.
Yesterday, we had your party mate, Governor Chis Escudero, on the show as well. He did confirm that he's also going to run for the Senate. And I asked him about the kind of leader that the country needs. You sort of touched on that a while ago. He did say, though, that the person has got to be a healing president. But my question for you, Congresswoman, is, can healing begin without holding President Duterte accountable for the countless deaths, for the pandemic response? Yes. Go ahead.
First of all, I welcome Cheese, and I'd be happy to have him back in the Senate. Pray God that we could be together there. Yes, correct. A healing president, a unifying leader. But I would like to see which of those who will actually run will have a sustainable development agenda for a resilient, healthy, green Philippines. I want to see all the laws that I authored and, let's say, the pending legislation on natural resource accounting mainstreamed in the agenda of the next leader. Whatever lacking in the leaders now and in the past. Yes, I am certain that there are the mechanisms, both legal and political, both national and global, that will hold them accountable for every piece of action. But what in the agenda of everyone who will run for the highest and the second highest office, I would like to see the mainstreaming of sustainability, the mainstreaming of the climate agenda, because that is the only way we can actually recover from this pandemic, to bring about culture-based rural livelihoods, to bring about healthcare up to the barangay level, to bring about an educational system that will respond to even possible pandemics in the future.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. We've run out of time. Congresswoman Loren Legarda, nice to see you again. Continue to keep safe. Take care.
Thank you, Carmina.